Hey guys, in this video we will explore the full potential of automating Excel tasks using VBA and ChatGPT. In particular, I will show you how to easily extract data from multiple workbooks, send emails with personalized text and attachments, replace values in spreadsheets, and even how to automate the creation of pivot tables and charts. Okay, and without further ado, let us dive in.
Let us start by exploring how to consolidate data from multiple Excel files. In my input folder, I have a collection of files that all have the same structure. They contain a settings and a data worksheet. The data worksheet includes a collection of numbers, but I am more interested in the settings sheet. Specifically, I want to extract the country, entity, and name from each file. To do this, I asked ChatGPT to create a VBA script for the consolidated.xlsm workbook to extract values in cell A2, B2, and C2 from sheet settings from all Excel files in the input folder located in the same directory as my workbook. And it should insert the extracted values along with the source file name into my workbook in columns A, B, C, and D. After hitting enter, I received a VBA code and some explanations in return. All I had to do was copy this code into my consolidated workbook. So I opened the workbook, went to Developer, Visual Basic, inserted a new module, and pasted the code there. Before running any macro, I typically compile it first by clicking on the button under the debug menu. The code compiled without any errors, so I ran the code to see the results. Excel is now opening each file and is writing the values in my workbook. Once that was done, I received a message box. And this is what the result looks like. We have extracted the settings from each file, and in column D we can also see the corresponding workbook name. Of course, you could tweak the code further, such as setting application.screenUpdating to false to speed up the macro, or include additional error handling, but I think the code from ChatGPT is already a great starting point, and we achieved this with minimal effort. And with that said, let us move on to creating an email sender tool in Excel. To do this, I have an attachments folder where I keep all the files I want to send via email. To send these files, I have created the following spreadsheet. This workbook contains a table of email receivers, CC email addresses, recipient names, attachment file names, a subject, and a body. Additionally, I have done some further preparation. I converted this range into an Excel table and named it email list. For the subject, I used a named cell called subject, and I did the same for the body as well. This is not necessary, but I like to do it this way because it allows me to move the cells around, but the name of the cell will remain the same. Additionally, you will notice that I have included placeholders in the email body. So name should be replaced with the actual name in column C, and attachment should be replaced with the attachment name in column D. To generate the VBA code for this task, I asked ChatGPT to create a VBA macro that loops through the rows of the email list table in the distribution list worksheet. For each row, use the email receiver column for the recipient, email CC for the CC, and the name column to replace a name placeholder in the body cell. Also, it should replace the attachment placeholder with the corresponding value in the attachment column. Use the subject cell for the subject of the email, and also attach the file found in the attachments folder of the workbook's directory, using the attachment column to concatenate the file path. And lastly, send the email using Outlook. Although I received a warning that this prompt may violate the content policy, I still received the following VBA code. The formatting is slightly off, but that shouldn't be an issue. More importantly, the solution included a hint. The provided code assumes that the email receiver is in the second column, followed by the other fields. However, in my case, the email address is located in column A, so I need to fix this later. I copied the code, returned to my workbook, inserted a new module, pasted the code there, and compiled it. However, I received a compile error saying that the user-defined type is not defined. I could have asked ChatGPT to fix this error, but I already knew the solution. To interact with Outlook, I first needed to import the library by going to Tools, References, searching for Microsoft Outlook Object Library, and ticking the box next to it. Once that was done, I also fixed the column numbers. In my workbook, the recipient starts from column A, but the code assumes it is in column B. So I replace 2 with 1. And I did the same for the other columns. Also, the loop should start from row 2, as in the first row we have the headers. And for testing purposes, I only want to display the emails and not send them. After making these modifications, I executed the code and it created 3 emails for me. I dragged them down a bit to check if everything was correct. And it looked good to me. The receiver, CC, subject, attachment, and body were all correct. We can also see that the placeholders for the name and attachments have been replaced. From this example, we can see that ChatGPT did all the heavy lifting to create the code. However, if you want to modify it, it is good to have some knowledge of VBA. Nonetheless, you don't need to be an expert to create a tool like this. With that in mind, let us take a look at the next example. The use case is as follows. I have an input folder with a bunch of Excel files. Let me open up one. With all files and worksheets, I want to replace small business with small market and mid-market with mid-size market. The modified worksheets should be saved in an output folder. If that folder doesn't exist, VBA should create it. I asked ChatGPT if that would be possible. In response, it answered that it is possible and laid out how I could tackle this problem. I then asked for the complete VBA code and ChatGPT provided the following script. It is important to note the additional comments stating that we need to modify the input and output folder path. With that in mind, I grabbed this code, opened my workbook, inserted a new module, and pasted it in. I already like that it even created a separate function to check whether a given folder exists. However, when I compiled the code, I received an error stating that the input folder path was not defined, which was correct. The variables had not been declared as strings. So I went back to the chat and pasted the error message. ChatGPT recognized the issue and said that those two variables should be defined before using them. However, in the modified version, they had still not been declared. So I decided to do it myself. I declared input folder path and output folder path as strings and also fixed the input and output folder paths. For my example, both file paths should be in the same directory as the current workbook. I recompiled the code and this time there was no error, so I decided to give it a try and run the code. Once it was done, I received a message box. When I minimized Excel, I could see that a new output folder had been created. Within this folder, I found my new workbook. To validate that the changes had been made, I opened one file and saw that small business had been replaced with small market and mid-market with mid-size market. I think the results are pretty impressive and this can be a real time saver. Okay, and for the last example, let's see if we can speed up our analysis in the following workbook. We have some financial data for different countries and I would like to automatically insert a pivot table and create a bar chart to display the aggregated sales by product. I asked ChatGPT, using VBA, can you please group the data in the worksheet data in column J, so the sales, by column C, so the products. Additionally, can you create an Excel bar chart from the grouped product sales and place it in a new worksheet called analysis? And those two sentences were already enough to receive the following VBA code. I copied the code, inserted a new module, and pasted it in. The code compiled without any errors, so I gave it a shot and executed it. However, I received an error saying that VBA could not get the group property from the range class. I took this error message and pasted it into the chat. I then received a new version of the code. I took this modified version and replaced my code. Yet this time I received another error message when creating the pivot table. However, I noticed that in my workbook, the pivot table had been already created. So I decided to comment out those lines to see if it could also generate the pivot chart. And indeed, after commenting out the lines and running the rest of the code, we now had a bar chart with the product sales. But looking at the available fields, I noticed that some columns were missing. So I deleted the sheet and went back to the VBA code. I set the data range from column A to P to include all data. I also removed the lines I had commented out. Now if I rerun it, we have our pivot table and chart as before, but this time we also have all columns available so that I can filter my data further. I think these examples are pretty amazing. With just a little knowledge of VBA, you can take full advantage of ChatGPT and speed up all your workflows. And I imagine the results and code from ChatGPT will only improve in the future. So, what is your opinion about ChatGPT? Let me know in the comments. And as always, thanks for watching and see you in the next video.